France was organizing the European Championship on its own soil, and we played in Paris. Unfortunately, I was injured. I had broken my leg in March. Copa and Piantini were also injured, and so they could not play in the semi-final. France could have won. They were leading 4-2, quarter of an hour before the end of the match, and they lost 5-4 against Yugoslavia.
Just Fontaine continued playing for France until breaking his leg once more.
My only regret was not being able to play, because it was a source of great pleasure to me. I'm not thinking about the money. We did not earn very much at the time. In the last four matches I played in the French team in 1960, I scored 9 goals. So I was in fine form when it happened. I would have liked to continue for a few more years, but unfortunately, perhaps it was easier then for me to adapt to a new career. So it is fate, and one has to accept it. The other players, I received a grant from the sports committee here at Lucernik. If they were from a factory-based team, players were paid their factory wages. If they were from an army team, as officers, they received their officers' pay. So there was no official status under the previous regime. And not forgetting our team spirit. Since we have been brought up with communist beliefs of one for all and all for one, and this helped us succeed. We had a good team, but the final is the final. I think it was particularly interesting. We had determined players. Under stress, both teams were trying to win. I remember everything. Players do not forget matches like that. The match against Yugoslavia. In the second half, the Soviets took the initiative. Metrovelli equalized. The extra time went to our advantage. And in the 12th minute, I received a pass from Meski and headed in the second decisive goal. After our victory in 1960, with our organization working to a high standard, they announced that we would appear at Lucernik Central Stadium in front of 100. We received a lot of invitations. The boss of Real Madrid was in Paris at the match, and he immediately invited several of us to go to his club, but we were not allowed to go. Times were different then, and we could not sign contracts. But foreign clubs very much wanted to invite Soviet players,